Delilah, what's it like in New York City? I'm 1,000 miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty. Yes, you do. Times Square can't shine as bright as you. I swear it's true. Hey there, Delilah, don't you worry about the distance. I'm right there if you get lonely. Give this song another listen. Close your eyes. Listen to my voice, it's my disguise. I'm by your side. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 What you do to me.
And now Rachel Alexander's opening up. 5 lengths on the field. 6. Oh, a tour de force by the Super Filly, Rachel Alexander. Kevin Morrell isn't moving a muscle on her. She's going to destroy this field.
Finite broke sharp. His glory, Ursula the Gray, is right there. Impeccable Style in fourth position as they head toward the first turn. A walking odds leader. His glory at the inside for James Graham as they enter the first turn. It's His glory who takes the shortest way around there from Ursula, Swiss Skydiver, and Finite is running in the three path as they go to the back of the track with His glory, the overall leader. Impeccable Style drafting in behind Phillies, the champion. British Idiom is racing three deep as they go to 6 furlongs from home and a break of 4 more to Tempers Rising, who trails the three-year-old Phillies Septet. The quarter for His glory, a 27-1 leader, 24.20 seconds. They have 5 furlongs to go. His glory generates the pace, tracked by Ursula. Finite is 3 wide uncovered for Ricardo Santana Jr., looking to draw in. The inside is Swiss Skydiver, who's saving ground, heading past the half-mile pole. On the outside now gaining British Idiom. He's picking up for Javier Castellano as they turn again. The trailer's Impeccable Style, but Tempers Rising. Half mile for His glory in 47.92. This is 3 furlongs from home. His glory continues to lead. Ursula, Finite now, gearing up for a run. And here's Finite, who's coming to take on His glory. Ursula, British Idiom, now coming under pressure and sweeps in the four path as they straighten past the quarter pole. Three quarters at 112.64. It's Finite. Finite in a fight with His glory. British Idiom still has 3 legs to raise, and Swiss Skydiver is charging hard now as they come down to the final 16th. It's Finite. Finite leads by 4. British Idiom, Swiss Skydiver, His glory, and Tempers Rising with Ricardo Santana Jr. It's Finite, and Finite wins the Rachel Alexander Stakes.
You can breathe, I suppose, watching this race than the last race for you.
True. I mean, she got it done a little easier. You know, like I was just saying that Yeah, the last race we were hoping she'd step up this race, and you know, you always hope that they do that, but with racehorses they don't do what we expect them to do a lot of times, so it's nice that she was able to get that done.
You've won the Kentucky Oaks twice before. I mean, just, how do you feel about this filly and the characteristics she has as far as looking way ahead?
Well, we're trying to repeat for the third time. We did the same path here with the Rachel Alexander, I think it was Silver Bullet Day back then, with the other two horses that we won the Oaks with, so you know, obviously we're trying to do the same thing and repeat it times three.
Love it. I mean, she's a filly, you know, ideal circumstances to run under today. I mean, it feels great. The racetrack's in super shape. We had very smooth time between the Silver Bullet Day and today's Rachel Alexander with her. And I thought the key to it and stuff, she was away cleanly in Ricardo's hands and very comfortable the whole race.
Is there anything that you see different in training or anything different?
I think that she did get a little bit of a freshening somewhat off of the Golden Rod before the Silver Bullet Day, and I thought she was a little anxious in the paddock before the Silver Bullet Day and ran well. But at this time of year, you know, with the three-year-old, you need to be better next time, you know, and I think that she is better today than she was in the Silver Bullet Day, and we will need to continue to improve to end up where we want, and that's with her winning the Kentucky Oaks.
A fantastic effort on her behalf. You know, this filly's had three races since we ran our last race. So, I'm very pleased with our filly. I really, really am. We had, a wide truck, both turns, and run on down the lane and got a little tired late. And, you know, I thought that something would come into play. And, I think she'll look good here in 5 weeks. I really do think she'll look good.
I mean, she's not even back to the spit box. Any sense, would she stay or would you go in the Ashland like you did with my boy girl?
It's an option, or the fairgrounds open.
She used way to turn from once when I asked her to go. When I asked her to go, she gave me a really nice feature. I'm really happy with her.
It's like last time, so you're feeling good about finance.
Yes, I hope we